game, Steve Berline has a change in offense, but still the blazing speed of wide receiver Tim Brown to spread excitement across the field. ABC Sports presents... Football. The Michigan Wolverines and the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame.
The University of Michigan Wolverines.
10-1-1 last year, ranked second in the final polls. Coach Bo Schembechler, 18th season at Michigan, 156 wins and 198 games. And now, the other reason for the record number of media people, this man, Lou Holtz, taking over as the head football coach of the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. Game number one is at hand. Listen to this sound as they come out of the tunnel. Fastest. He's back there along with Jamie Morris and John Kearney, a senior out of West Palm Beach, Florida, will kick off for the Fighting Irish. The Fabledo Stadium is stuffed again. The grass is in fine shape. The field is firm, and the game is on. And we look now to the opening of play by Michigan. Look at the weights on the offensive front, averaging 285. Jokic, the split end, weighs a mere 239, but he makes up for that in the fact that he's 6'8" high. A big, big target and a big, big line, and those fellas can move it around. But as Bo said, they're all playing new positions, or they have not played any position for any period of time. Let's see how they fare in the opening series. First down from their 20. Kolasar and Jokic are the wide people. Jim Harbaugh steps in at quarterback. The deep man is Jamie Morris. Notre Dame shuffling linebackers in and out. It goes to Morris. Morris trying to get around the corner. Goes no place. Loses 4 yards as Ron Weissenhofer was able to penetrate and get to him along with Ernie Holloway. The offensive backfield, Harbaugh the quarterback and Morris the tailback, the two key people. Jerry White in there at fullback. Harbaugh is a big fella, stands well over 6 feet. Jamie Morris is a little fella, 5'7", 180 pounds, which means he can get in behind there sometimes and hide. You can't find him. And by the time you get through sifting and sorting out, he's gone. But he didn't go that time. Give him a 3 yard loss on the first carry. Second down and 13. Harbaugh rolls it left. Good protection, lobs his pass out to White. White cuts it to the 27 and goes down there. And I think it is very, very obvious that Notre Dame has come out jacked up. The Notre Dame defensive unit, Kovaleski, is the inside backer there, and he'll be very, very important all day. Mike is a senior out of Newcastle, Indiana. We look at him, and he's a tough, good, solid football player. Set up in a wishbone formation. They have practiced it. Bob Perryman is in there at fullback on third down and 3. Option play goes to the right side to the big fullback, and he's got a first down. And there's your first surprise of the ball game.
Keith, it is an offense that Michigan has worked on and worked on a great deal in preparation for this game. You will see Michigan use that wishbone attack in short yarded situations like that one and down in close by the goal line. And of course, everybody knows the asset, the biggest plus of the wishbone is every play starts the same way. So it's very difficult to read, twice as tough to prepare for.
Now they go back to the split back formation as the wishbone worked, or the option offense worked the first time. Handoff goes to Jamie Morris. Morris goes from the 31 to about the 32, and he is cut down there. The officials in today's ball game, a mixed crew of the Central Independent Association and the Big Ten. The referee is John Nealon.
Notre Dame, as you mentioned, is very jacked up right now, very high. But what they have to be concerned with is that old adage that emotion sometimes gets in the way of concentration. They cannot afford a breakdown, a mistake, a mental error here, and give up the big play.
Second down and eight. Michigan goes to a double tight end alignment as Derek Walker checks into the ball game and Kolasar comes out. Harbaugh fakes it left, turns it right, naked bootleg, looks down the middle, throws the ball, complete to Jeffrey Brown, is tied in, and Brown is up for a first down close to midfield. Beautiful play there.
All right, this is exactly what I was talking about. You'll see, here's the waggle play. In other words, all the motion goes one way and the quarterback goes the other. Notre Dame has already lost containment. There's nobody on the outside, so Harbaugh has the option to run or throw. When everybody comes up to grab him, then the receiver Brown is wide open.
And Kolasar, speed man, checks back in for Michigan. First down near midfield for the Wolverines. Opening offensive series of the ball game. Up man, White, the fullback. Right guard gets in behind the big fella Dames, a mere 260, but Hussar at 290 is also over there, and there is some daylight. Vitale, the center, weighs in at 290. There's a gain on the play of about four, second down and six coming up. In replacing Jokic at wide receiver. Higgins number 31 to the bottom of the picture. I formation this time for Michigan on second down and six. Irish Thompson around defensively, showing a five-man front. Foge Fazio now the defensive coordinator for Notre Dame. Little man Morris carries the ball. 5'7", 180 from Ayer, Massachusetts, and Jamie, the younger brother of Joe, who plays for the New York Giants, is going to be marked down at the 43. So you're looking at third down, 2.5.
He is tough to find in there. He's only 5'7". We said the offensive line is tall. They're big. They average 285 pounds. So that's problem number one. Also, Morris has a very low running style. He stays down, has good vision. And you'll watch him pick and run.
Merriman comes back in. They go back into the wishbone formation now. Last time they worked it for a first down. It's third down and a short three. Harbaugh goes down the line with the ball, turns the corner, first down and then some. Down to the 30-yard line. Gerald White made the big block to turn Harbaugh upfield.
All right, if you haven't seen the wishbone very often, it's very tough to defend against. Now, that middle guard has to take that dive, man. There's the fake. Now, Harbaugh comes down. He options that end. See the end running with the pitch man? Then he picks up this block here from White. Great cut by Harbaugh. We told you in the pregame that he can run. That's going to be very difficult to stop for Notre Dame.
The Wolverines first down at the Notre Dame 30. Straight back to pass on first down. Ball is batted down by the big man on the defensive line for Notre Dame, Wally Klein, 6'9", 275.
Wally Klein could be the tallest man in college football at 6'9", and he's going to cause some problems for Harbaugh, who's 6'4". When he puts those arms up, he's tough to throw over. Now, he's coming off knee surgery. He's had some bad shoulders. He does come in too high, and that causes some problems for him on the run. But as a pass defender, boy, he's tough to throw against.
Second down and 10. Kolasar comes to the bottom of the picture now. Jokic goes to the top. And Harbaugh gives the ball to Jamie Morris, bouncing in the middle. And picks up yardage to the 25. He got a good five on that carry. Close to six before Klein brought him down. Wally is a senior out of Midland, Texas. Jamie Morris, a big year last year, as you can see. That's a good average. Five plus.
You know, Jamie Morris was not even recruited by Bo. Kid just wanted to come to Michigan. Got a questionnaire, filled it out, became the first freshman in Michigan to lead the team in rushing since 1945, and he's most valuable player of the Fiesta Bowl.
Now you've got three wideouts in the lineup for Michigan on third down and five, and Harbaugh is back to throw. Has a lot of time. Sideline thrown too high, and the ball was really thrown over the head of Jamie Morris. Because as Jamie went up and got a hand on it, he was out of bounds. So it brings up a fourth down, and in comes the kicking unit now with Pat Moons, a senior from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, in to try the field goal, and it's from a heady distance.
of 42 yards. 9.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. The holder is Monty Robbins, the punter. Last year, Moons was 1 for 1 from this distance. Plenty of leg on it. And he missed it. He hooked it up. And so the crowd cheers as Michigan comes away with nothing after controlling the ball for the better part of 6.5 minutes. And here's the first snap of the Irish under the coaching of Lou Holtz. Goes to Green. He's cut down after a couple of yards up to about the 27-yard line. Williams, Sproul, Heffern. Where Heffern goes normally is where the play is. Lanza, Freeman, Reeder. Jackson not in there. Alvin Miller is starting. Jackson has a bit of an injury, but may play some today. So it's second down and call it 8. For Notre Dame at their own 27, and they go double wide to the left side. Alvin Miller is 6'4", 210, a speedster out of Kirkwood, Missouri, at the top of the picture. Berline will whip it upfield, throws it quickly to Mark Green, who had been a wide receiver, but crept out that time into a flanker position. But he had been converted into the tailback spot, and that time he went back to that wide spot and picked up a first down. Tim Brown, the other wide man, has got to be a key personality in this ball game because he's the swiftest of the swift out there today.
But the single biggest factor here has to be Steve Berline. He has to perform well for Notre Dame to win today. He's thrown 37 career interceptions. He can't afford any mistakes like that against Michigan.
The ball is marked out at the 42, where it's first down for the Irish. Split back formation. Ball goes to Green, and Green spinning with a tackler gets up across the 45 to the 47, where he is hauled down. And Andy Moeller in the middle at the inside backer position is bound to be a key man today for the Michigan defensive people and was involved in the last play. Garland Rivers at cornerback is the hitter. He might do anything.
That's exactly right. But Andy Moeller is the son of Gary Moeller, the defensive coordinator, thinks like his dad, reacts a little bit better.
A little younger. This is Tim Brown, the wide receiver, running a reverse for the Irish. And Brown at 6'2", 190, a junior out of Dallas, Texas. Just give him a crack and he's gone, and he picked up a first down with that carry.
You can see the Lou Holtz factor already in this ball game. Last year, Notre Dame was very predictable. It was Alan Pinkett right, Alan Pinkett left, Alan Pinkett straight up the middle. Already we've seen two different formations. We've seen several plays that have gone to the outside, set up the run. There may be some ghosts in this place. Notre Dame looks fairly strong in this offensive series.
I think they will play the game very tight, tough and close, perhaps as long as three quarters. But manpower eventually may become a problem for them. That's the bottom line of this contest. Brown trying to bounce outside with it. That time is unable to do it as Michigan read it early. And Steve Thiebert, 6'5", 240 from Union Lake, Michigan, brings him down. He's an outside backer to the right side.
Notre Dame certainly doesn't have only the 8th losing season in the school's history, but all 5 wins came here at Notre Dame Stadium against some bowl teams like Michigan State, Army, Southern Cal.
Second down. About 13. Berline's pass is complete. Caught by number 8, Andy Heck, sophomore, Annandale, Virginia, and nailed by Garland Rivers. Now, Heck is 235-pounder, number 88 there. Rivers is 185-pounds. He's giving away 50 pounds, and he put him on his back.
Garland Rivers reacts very well to the football, and he does play with reckless abandon. He doesn't care how big you are. He's just going to get in and put that Rydell under your chin. He knows that the key is not size, but it's leverage, and he sure has that.
It's third down and a long 7 now for the Irish. The ball is at the Michigan, just inside the Michigan 44. As Berline rolls and throws, good to Miller. And Miller has a first down for the Irish at the 32-yard line.
Berline has been impressive thus far. Now, Lou Holtz told me yesterday that this kid has improved tremendously. Says he's a maligned quarterback. Said he hadn't thrown an interception the entire fall practice. But throwing against your own guys is a lot easier than throwing against Michigan. But thus far, Michigan stayed rather
brown for the moment as Notre Dame goes to the I formation. Green the deep man. And Taylor the up man. And Taylor has the ball. And he dives into the middle to about the 30 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Oh.
Brown is coming back in now after a conversation with Lou Holtz, so it's obvious he's bringing a play at 6:15 to go in the first quarter and no score. Line rolls it that way, looks down the middle, goes into the end zone for Miller, and it is incomplete. He went as high as he could. Number 8, Doug Mallory, went up with him along with Tony Gant, and he could not make the play. Split in, another speedster, and Berline goes straight back on third down. Little shovel pass ahead to Taylor. Taylor's got some blocking in front of him. He's got a first down inside the 20. Well, Lee Grosskopf and the old Utes will love that, because it's suddenly become a very pet play for a lot of football teams.
Old Cactus Jack, he's the one that originated it. This is a forward pass, but if he drops the ball, it's not a fumble because it's incomplete. Now, it's run blocking on the play. You pull your guard, you get him out in front. I love that play. I told you Lou Holtz was doing it with mirrors. He sure is. That's deception.
First down at the 19-yard line for the Irish. Michigan's 19. Berline to Green. And Mark Green, who comes out of Riverside, California, 6-footer, 185, goes right into the stack. And the question on Mark is, how much pounding can he take at the running back position? Because last year he was in a wide spot. Notre Dame goes into a wishbone set now with a veer option. And Berline comes down the line, flips it back to Green. Green's on the corner. He's inside the 10. He's inside the 5. He's out of bounds at the 3. First and goal, Irish.
The wishbone, every play starts the same. The key is the quarterback. He rides the dive man. Now he's got to read that outside guy. There's the read at the attack. Green gets a great block from the wide receiver Brown out there. Then he turns it on the corner. They're inside the 5. I was convinced, Keith, that Michigan scored first, it'd be Katie bar the door. If Notre Dame scores, this may be a ball game.
I believe it'll be a contest if Notre Dame gets in front, and they've got a great chance now. First down and goal from the 3. They stay in the wishbone. They pitch it back to Tim Brown. Brown bounces outside. Foot race to the corner. Touchdown. First offensive possession, take the football and stick it in the end zone on this run by Tim Brown. Thirteen plays, they go 75 yards to lead it 7-0. Notre Dame, Steve Berline, 4 out of 5 in that drive, 42 yards and 3 first downs. The Irish lead 7-0. Carney will kick off now with Colasar and Morris deep for Michigan. Into the end zone, way back, no return. Let's join Al Trautwig.
Keith, you know, the Wolverine helmets have always interested me. This design is certainly strange. It doesn't look like a Wolverine, and well, it's not. You know, the longtime innovative coach of Michigan.
Stability downfield. Don't have any trouble spotting your receivers, that's for sure. First down, Wolverine. They trail. Give it to Morris. Morris from the 20. Jamie's out to the 25. Second down and 5 coming up. We'll take one more look at Tim Brown's touchdown run put on that previous carry. Harbaugh back to throw it. Gets it off down the middle. Colasar's there, and he's got it for a first down at the Irish 40. Caught it in front of Arv Spence. Perfect throw and a fine catch by Colasar.
Anytime a team goes to a zone defense, especially a two-deep zone, you've got to put that safety in the middle of the field. Well, Notre Dame did that, but by the time they did it and he reacted and readjusted after hesitating, Colasar was into the secondary. You beat that two-deep zone, or you beat any zone, by going to the middle. Colasar ran a post pattern and he was clear in the seam.
So they pick up a bundle and mark it at the 41-yard line, not the 40. Colasar goes in motion on this play. And it goes to the up man, White. And Gerald White wedges to about the 36. So that's a pickup of about 5 yards there as Kobolewski brings him down.
Kovalevsky is the bell cow. He is the leader on that defense, the most experienced guy there. He started 3 years. Now, here he is right in the middle. He gets low. He meets the blocker. Now, he's got to shed the blocker and get to the play, but he's getting tied up there. Now, he gets off and makes the tackle. That Michigan offensive line is so big. Boy, how times have changed. Remember the Fordham seven blocks of granite? Three of those guys weighed less than 190 pounds.
Yeah, the whole game's changed. Second down and five. This is Gerald White. White breaks a tackle on the right side, picks up a first down. As he cracks inside the 30 and gets to the 26, free safety Mike Haywood came up to bring him down. So Michigan showing some offensive spark and responding to the Irish touchdown. Next, Sam Morris in the eye. Harbaugh to Morris. Morris disappears in the stack, but once again shows his strength and being built low to the ground, as strong as he is. It didn't look like there was anything there for him, but he's still got 4 yards.
He runs a lot like his brother Joe, who's with the Giants. They both have that low center of gravity. Even if they were bigger backs, if they had that quality, it'd be a tremendous asset. You stay low to the ground, you give up a...
Harbaugh to Morris. Morris hit at the line of scrimmage, breaks a tackle, touchdown.
This now. This play's been in the books for years. The old counter, the fake one way. Here comes the cross buck. But watch, it's Banks again who gets tied up and doesn't wrap his arms. He feels awkward in a new position right now. I'm not saying he's not going to adjust because he's a great athlete. But that time he missed the tackle and Morris bounced outside for the touchdown.
And Pat Moons is in now to try to tie it up. And he does. We've got 33 seconds to play in the first quarter. It's a 7-7 ball game, and an impressive note, not a single flag as yet.
In more games than any other Division 1A institution, compiling a record of 665 wins, 223 losses, and 32 ties.
As Berline drops to throw on first down, wants to go deep, does go deep for Brown as far as he can throw it, and it's an incomplete forward pass. No interference on that call. Ivan Hicks was covering him all the way.
No, but right away you hear the crowd. They want that interference called. Incidental contact. Tim Brown just adjusted his route, changed his head direction, look over the opposite shoulder, and they bumped and he fell.
So it brings up second down and 10 from the 27 for Notre Dame. 7-7 tie with 22 seconds to play in the first quarter. Berline gives the ball away to number 46. That's Pernell Taylor, a senior out of La Puente, California. And he's got a couple of yards up to about the 29. As time now will probably run out in the first quarter, they might take a little extra time during the quarter break to talk about what they'd like to do. And so after 15 minutes in South Bend, Notre Dame Stadium, it's Michigan 7 and Notre Dame 7. Brown is wide to the bottom of the picture. Berline will throw it on third and long. Goes the other way. Pass is caught by Mark Green. Swinging out of the backfield. Goes for a first down at the 40. Brought down by Garland Rivers. Well, they've got Michigan thinking Brown, and he went the other way.
Well, he did something else, too. He sent guys deep down the middle, and he looked it that way and actually pumped in their direction. That cleared out things in the flat for Green. And when Green got out there, there was no linebacker in sight, so he made the catch, cut inside, and got the first down.
Just outside the 40 for the Irish. So they keep the ball as they convert on third and long. Same alignment. Berline drops, short drop, quick pass, incomplete. He had that one going toward Alvin Miller. The stats off the first quarter look this way.
All right, look at the total yards. 135 total yards for Michigan. And the time of possession, 9 minutes and 36 seconds they had the football. Now, this is the biggest concern Lou Holtz has, is the Notre Dame defense. They have to stop Michigan. Boy, that's a team, Notre Dame, that was outscored in the final three games last year, 140-20. They gave up more points and more yards than they had in 30 years, more touchdown passes in the history of the school. The defense right now is a little bit shaky.
Reggie Ward is in there at a flanker spot now. Berline gives the ball to Ward on a reverse play. Has a block on the corner. Springs it. Picks up a first down as he crosses midfield and goes to the Michigan 47-yard line. Garland Rivers brought him down. Otherwise, he would be long gone. Penalty flag, first one of the ball game, and it's called against Michigan. Big one.
Got a dead ball, personal foul, Michigan. First down.
Boy, that offense is gaining confidence now, isn't it? Lou Holtz, great, brilliant game plan here. He's using a lot of different things, a lot of formations. What he's doing is taking a very big, strong, basic, solid Michigan defense, and he's spreading them out across the field.
And it's Irish first down at the Wolverine 31. Berline hands to Green. Big hole right side. Mark Green, first down inside the 20 to the 17. And that time, somebody missed a count. So that'll be a penalty against the Irish. Rutgers and Kentucky right in the chase up in the western part of the country this year. Don James, fine program. On first down and 15, Berline roll left. A lot of protection, a lot of time. Looking, nobody there. Goes to the sidelines, and he's out at the 15-yard line.
Well, the crowd wanted a penalty for being hit late out of bounds. I think it was just the momentum that carried him that way. Interesting guy, Steve Berline. Lou Holtz said he's the most maligned quarterback he's ever seen, says that he has played extremely well. Berline self-admittedly says...
Ball fumble, Michigan covers it at the 6-yard line. So let's see, we may have a penalty call against the Irish, and if that's the case, Michigan will surely decline it and keep the ball. Reggie Ward was the man with the ball, and he lost control of it, and it bounced right down in front of a Michigan man, and I didn't get his number. It could have been Dieter Herron. It could have been any one of about three of them that covered the ball. Or it could have been Gant, Tony Gant.
Well, here it is again now. Again, it's a good play, and it would have been a big gainer. But he runs right out of his shoes right here. He gets kicked. The ball comes right out of his arms. I think he was just thinking a little bit too much about what his move was going to be. He was looking to the outside, checked to the inside. And while he was doing all that, the ball just got away from him. Nonetheless, it's still 7-7.
Hey, there's a flag thrown for motion, and then Reggie Ward fumbled it. Michigan covered it. Michigan declines, takes the ball. First down, it's just short of their 7-yard line in a 7-7 game with 13:30 to go in the first half. Harbaugh at quarterback. They come out in the wishbone with White, Perriman, and Morris lined up behind Harbaugh. Big man Perriman carries it. Maybe a yard, that'll do it. As he just tried to wedge up the middle, and Mike Griffin, who has come off of a season missed because of injury, is back in there at that nose tackle. Marty Lippincott got the start today, but Griffin out of Cleveland Heights, Ohio, figures to play a lot this season.
Griffin hadn't played in a year and a half, so he may be a little bit rusty, but that time he made a nice play. Stayed low, got the blocker off of him, and made the tackle.
Second down, long 8 or short 9, however you like it. They picked up a yard and a half on the play. That's Kolasar in motion. Ball goes to Jamie Morris. Morris cuts it back into the... Nope, it is White. Gerald White carrying, and White gets it up across the 10. So it'll be third down at about 7 as the 6'8 wide receiver is yet. They go back to the I formation, and Harbaugh is back to throw this time, getting some pressure, and he's out of bounds at the 5. Robert Banks that time made the play.
He is a talent. Now, we said he had a tough time adjusting to his new position in the first quarter, and he did. He lost outside containment. He didn't wrap up on a tackle, and it cost him a touchdown. But Banks is an outstanding athlete. Good speed becomes excellent.
Out of the back of his end zone, averaged just over 40 last year per kick. Pressure's on him. He gets it out. High kick, no spin on it. It's going to be a short kick. And it takes a Notre Dame bounce back upfield. Oh, boy. Haywood comes hobbling off the free safety for Notre Dame. He hurt an ankle on the play. But more importantly, Robbins gets only a 23-yard punt. And if the Michigan man hadn't grabbed the ball, go into a wishbone formation with Brown. Brown has it, and Brown goes to the 20. Picked up 6 yards on the carry, brought down by Garland Rivers.
I'll tell you, I would throw a flag on that one. Number 14, Tony Gant, Michigan's defensive back, came in and actually speared Brown when he was on the ground. That's illegal. You can't use that helmet as a weapon, and you can't spear.
Second down, a little more than 4 yards for the Irish, just short of the 20 of Michigan. Five-man front for the Wolverines. Berline to Green. Green is caught and brought down by Todd Schulte, one of the twin brothers on the Michigan team. The other is Tim. In fact, there are three twin brothers on the Michigan varsity roster.
If he didn't make that tackle, kiss it goodbye.
Three sets of twins, I guess, is the proper way to put it.
He was the last man between him and the goal line.
That's right. It is now third and three. And the Irish go to the wishbone. Berline back to throw it. All day. Wings it away to Jackson. And Jackson is knocked out of bounds just short of the 15. Close to the first down. May have it. Mark is good. Yes, he has it. At the 15. Andre McIntyre knocked him out of bounds.
Interesting play. When you go to the wishbone, the true wishbone, you have one wideout, and that guy's usually covered man-to-man. That's exactly what you want to do. Milt Jackson is a big, strong receiver with good speed. You get him man-to-man, 9 times out of 10, if you get the ball anywhere near him, he's going to make the catch. It's an ideal passing situation for the Irish.
First down at the Michigan 15. Brown. Good surge by the offensive right this game. This is Brown carrying, and once again he's got the better part of 4 yards as he's inside the 10 to near the 7.
Well, Michigan wanted a fumble. They aren't going to get it. Brown can't cause a fumble. He had it when he went down. This guy, he does remind me of Gary Anderson. Now watch this cut. Up and over. Almost got tangled up with his own blocker. The ball comes loose there. Timmy Brown. He sang in a church choir in his hometown since the 9th grade. Still does, still will continue. Today he's got a lot of other things on.
Tim Brown, sweep right, two blockers, cuts it back, 5-yard line, first and goal, Notre Dame. I tell you, when the kid turns it with authority, doesn't he?
He really does. I get a kick out of Lou Holtz. He was painting the moon blue and saying how slow his team was. He said, if we run a sweep, we may get called for delay of game. These guys can run. And they got some blockers out in front, turned it up. They've had great success on the corners against Michigan. Now, they will continue to go back there. But the thing that's been impressive about Notre Dame's offense is, even though they've had success there, they continue to mix their plays. Run, pass, up the middle, little bit of deception, little bit of fakery, play action.
Brown is out of the game now, and Ward goes back in. They go to the I formation, and Mark Green pounds it over the left side and goes to the Michigan 1-yard line. Back in.
I'd put a guy on Tim Brown right now and go with him wherever he goes.
Second down and goal from the 1. Green over the top. Touchdown. Good. 8:08 to go, and the Irish regain the lead, 14-7.
Forget the woes of last year. Notre Dame has spread them out, made them thin. Look, they made the first down on the corner. Now they come right back to the middle after they spread the defense out. Mark Green goes right up and over.
So we do indeed have a contest as the Irish lead it, 14-7.
Down there yesterday.
Yep. From the 35 this year, the Collegians are kicking off. 8:08 to go in the first half. 14-7. Notre Dame leads. Carney to kick it. Morris and Colasar, the deep people for Michigan. Sailing kick that is out of here. Now Al Trotwig.
Well, Keith, it may not be the most comfortable seat in the house, but section 28, row 22, seat 14 is pretty darn good.
First down for the Wolverines at the 20. They trail by 7. Colasar comes in motion. Harbaugh sets him and gives to Jamie Morris. Pops it up the middle. He was caught at the line of scrimmage. Somebody had a hold of the ball. Marty Lippincott grabbed him by the arm and the ball. But once again, Jamie shows his strength and picks up 3.
Now there's a guy, 5'7", 175 pounds, Jamie Moore. Lippincott grabbed his arm and the football. Lippincott, 6'6", 275. You'd think he'd be able to yank that football out of there rather easily from a little guy, but Jamie Moore has held on and got positive yardage out of it.
Second and 7. Harbaugh's pass thrown to Morris underneath. Lost his footing on his cut. Knee hit the ground. They'll mark him at the 30, just short of the first down. If he doesn't slip, he might have broken a big one.
This is what it looked like from the stands. About the same side of the stadium as Owl. Just grab that man's seat. Notre Dame comes in the zone defense. Moore slips underneath. Fairly safe play. Got the first down.
He got a pretty good mark, too. I thought his knee was, he hit the ground back around the 27, but they've given him to the 30. And he's got the first down.
You know, those marks are shaky. I've never agreed with a referee when he's ready to mark the ball. I used to try to go and argue with him, say, hey, wait a minute, he fell down back there.
Never won either, did you?
Rarely.
Into the middle. That time, Jamie Morris is covered by a lot of folks in dark blue. It'll be second down and 7 at halftime. Jim Lampkin will be back with scores and highlights, and there have been some surprises across the country and undoubtedly more to come. It always happens the first 4 weeks of the season. Pitch out Morris. Look for the reverse. Colasar's got it. Coming around. Got blockers in front of him. Shakes one and gets a first down. Took some punishment, but he got it out of bounds at the 43. Troy Wilson and Robert Banks were the people coming back to get him.
All right, watch the bottom of your screen now. You have to wonder where the pursuit is. See 56 there? He's the trail man. He's got to stay on the outside leg of that ball carrier so that if anything does come back his way, he'll be there to make the tackle. He doesn't. All right, now here he comes and tries to make up for it. Oh, he got a pretty good lick. But then it's too late. It's already downfield, first down. He's having a tough time adjusting back there, Keith.
Well, outside linebacking position's a little different in that defensive tackle spot. Takes some time. Ball just short of the 44 where it's first down, Michigan. And Harbaugh, quick snap, quick step. Can't find anybody downfield. Gives to Jamie Morris. And Jamie just turns it upfield and takes what he can get. And he takes the lick from Marv Spence and Cedric Figaro. Figaro having been injured early, coming back to the ball game, a senior out of Lafayette, Louisiana. Jamie walking a little gingerly as he comes back to the huddle. Harriman comes in, and Morris will come out. So that'll move Gerald White to the tailback position with Perriman playing fullback. White, durable, double duty kind of a ball player. Second down and about five. White with the ball. Straight ahead he goes. First down. Power football. Michigan style to the 42 of Notre Dame. Been very effective today. He's carried four times. His runs were 4, 5, 9, and 9. Steve Lawrence is in at free safety, replacing Mike Haywood. Mike was skimpy after injuring an ankle, apparently. This is Perriman, the big fullback, and he breaks it over the left side and picks up 3, 4, maybe even 5 yards by the time he is tumbled down. Wally Klein will get credit for the tackle.
It's going to be interesting to see how Lou Holtz does with depth problems, see how many people he plays, because right now Michigan in that big offensive front line, which I think is as big as any offensive line you may see in the NFL, and right now they're just pounding on Notre Dame, and that may take its toll late in the ball game.
Second down, a long five. Harbaugh back. Jokic is down the middle. Harbaugh doesn't see him. He's still down there and still available. The pass is thrown underneath to Kolasar, and Kolasar will go down just inside the 30. But that will be another Michigan first down. Jokic was available the long time, but by the time that Harbaugh saw him, he was running for his life.
Well, what Harbaugh did is he felt the pressure from the inside, and once he started rolling to his right, he couldn't see back tip down the middle to his left where Jokic was. But what he did do is he kept going out to that corner and made the cornerback and the outside people commit themselves to the run. And then once they did that, then he just dropped the ball over there.
Michigan's offense, 94 yards running, 94 yards passing. It's first down at the Notre Dame 29, 14-7 Irish lead. 4:05 to go first half. This is White. And White gets outside, sees three blue shirts out there, cuts it back and gets it to the 25. Give him four on that carry, brought down by Wes Pritchett. Coach Fazio is... they will succeed in time. Second down and six. Right now, they're protecting a 14-7 Irish lead. Harbaugh keeps it. Gets away from Banks. Harbaugh running around, throws to the sidelines. Kolasar at the 15 and knocked out at about the 13, and a penalty flag is thrown. Down on the sidelines, I think. I saw a man whip a yellow flag out of his pocket.
I believe it's going to be a personal foul, hitting late out of bounds. Oh, I tell you, you know, the best quality Harbaugh has, and he has plenty of them. Great, talented quarterback. But his best talent is right there. He's evasive. He's quicker than you think. He gains a lot of time by running around back there. He's got great feel. He can feel when you're behind him. He turns and he finds a receiver, no matter how late it is. Now, here comes the late hit.
There's
right
the late
here.
Hit right there. Number 12, Troy Wilson. Probably would have been all right if he hadn't thrown the elbow. But that's the fervor of the moment.
I can't comment on that. I could have been the most penalized man in the Atlantic Coast Conference, but it's not. You're not doing it to be belligerent. I think you're just doing it out of aggressiveness.
John Nealon defines it as personal foul out of bounds, and the ball goes down to the 6-yard line where it's Michigan first and goal to go at the Irish 6. First and goal. Now you got Jamie Morris back in the lineup with Perriman and White. Michigan goes back to the wishbone formation at 3:10 to go in the first half. Harbaugh keeps it, turns it upfield, and goes down at the 5. A yard on the play. Let me correct the call. It is first down and 4. First and 4. And now it is second down and about maybe 2.5. So they can get a first down without scoring here. Taking a man with it. Pitch, Morris. Jamie Morris, hole up the middle. Closes quickly at the four. Wally Klein shut the door on him. Looked like he had a hole. He cut right back to it, but Klein was there.
We've talked a lot about the Notre Dame outside people. This time they make the play. Look at Klein, 96. Just strings the play out as far as he can go until Morris says, hey, wait a minute, I better cut this thing back up inside. As soon as he does, Klein sheds the blocker and makes the tackle. We've got Kovaleski now, Keith, with 11 tackles. So his dance card is full.
It certainly is. Third down and two. The ball is still at the five. Jokic wide to the top of the picture. Harbaugh gives it to Morris. Stacked up at the line of scrimmage, maybe not even there. Lippin caught, hit him first. Figueroa sealed it. And he's short of the 5-yard line, and it's fourth down. And in comes the kicking tee in Pat Boone's hand.
Boy, I'll tell you, that'll pump up a defense. Whoa, it'll pump up the crowd as well.
Pat Moons, the senior, 23-yard try. It is good. At 52 seconds to go in the first half, Michigan has to settle for a field goal. They could not punch it in from the six. It's 14-10, Irish. Goal line stand. Here's the kickoff by Rick Sutkovich, goes to Tim Brown, 3-yard line. And Brown is back to about the 21, where Tim Schulte brings him down. And you've got 47 seconds to play in the first half. 14-10 the score, Notre Dame lead.
I don't blame those guys for jumping high. I've been hard on the defense. Here's the call. I've been hard on the Notre Dame defense. I've told you that Banks is having a tough time adjusting, and he is, but the key is, it's been like a rubber band defense. They've stretched, but they haven't broken down close, and they're getting better every series. If they can continue to improve, that's all the coaches can ask.
Penalty is against Michigan. Well, the Irish get pretty good field position here with 47 seconds to go in the first half.
Notre Dame schedule before he took the job.
Look at the time Michigan used in that scoring drive and wound up with only 3 points. So they back it up to the 30-yard line where Sutkovich will kick it again, and Brown now moves outside his own five to accept it. So they could get pretty good field position out of this. Good high hanging kick though, should get good coverage. Brown takes it up at the 14-yard line, gets to the outside. Loses his footing as he started to cut back at the 31. Make it 32.
He's fun to watch. Did you see him do that little tap dance at the end? He knew how close he was to breaking it. And when he tried to cut in, his foot came out from under him. A couple tacklers in the area, but he really felt he's the kind of guy that has that confidence and knows even if one or two guys still in the area, he can break it. He can turn it loose. He can get by him.
Anthony Johnson is checked in, a 6'1", 220-pound freshman from South Bend, Indiana. Local fella who stayed home to play football, and they think he's going to be a good one. Number 22. But he is now flanked or split wide to the bottom of the picture in a wide receiver spot. And Berline unloads it quickly to Jackson. Jackson makes the catch, got about there one-on-one, and a good open field tackle by number 15 for Michigan, David Arnold, a sophomore from Warren, Ohio.
Berline trying to get him up to the line with 28 seconds left.
Clock ticking along. First, second down, and four. Berline rolls it back, gets some heat, gets it away. Sideline thrown out of bounds, stops the clock. Irish have two timeouts remaining. Only 15 seconds to play at a wide receiver spot and goes in motion. And here's the pitch back to Johnson. Big hole for him. Anthony Johnson puts his head down and runs for the first down. At the Michigan 45, 9 seconds to play in the first half, and Irish have called a timeout, stopping the clock. They want one more shot at the end zone. Irish have their play. It's first down at the Michigan 45. Brown takes off. Berline pumps and looks down the middle and throws to Miller, and he dropped the ball. Alvin Miller had it down the middle. But looking back into the sun, and I'm not defending him, but he did look right back into the sun trying to find the ball, and he went right through his hand.
Keep in mind, Michigan is in a prevent defense, but Notre Dame had just burnt them inside with a run. They've loosened things up now. He gets into the seam. Now, he still has people behind him, but this is a catch, and if he makes it, which he should have, you've got a chip shot for Kearney. And three more points for Notre Dame. Looking back into the sun or not, he should have made the catch.
4 seconds to play in the first half. Erline drops. Got trips to the top of the picture. Puts it in the air as far as he can throw it, and it's incomplete. And the first half is over. So, the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, first time out under Lou Holtz, go to the clubhouse, leading 14-10 over Michigan. Back with the halftime activities after this message and a word from our local station.
For every man who wears Brute deodorant, there's a woman who'll always be glad that he did. Because a man who wears Brute deodorant is nice to be close to. Brute, it smells like a man.
Great.
Their time of possession improved. But I think, Keith, that we should make mention here that Bo Schembechler is one of the best in the locker room. Well, so is Lou Holtz, but Bo Schembechler was behind 9-3 at the half last year against Notre Dame, came back to win it. Behind in the Fiesta Bowl at half, came back to win it. And right now, that defense is having a tough time overcoming the loss of Mallory, Hammerstein, and Cochran off that Michigan defense. They've got to adjust and stop this Irish attack.
I would say that Bo does tend to deal with harsh reality at halftime if he's failing.
He does not mince words. He'll go right after you, tell you what he thinks. He also is great technically. He's fundamentally sound, and he'll make adjustments. But look at this. Here's the guy we talked about. Bo Valesky has 12 individual tackles. And we'll try to keep an eye on him in the second half because he's been playing up in the line of scrimmage. Then he'll drop back. He'll play. He'll move. He's given Harbaugh a different look. But whatever the case may be, wherever the ball goes, he gets into that offense. And one other note, Keith, very quickly. Michigan used 40 people. Notre Dame only used 35. And I think that big offensive line could wear the Irish down.
There's a final score. BYU came back to beat New Mexico by a point. And I'll tell you, those Cougars can put the points on the board. But New Mexico has come out storming. They lost to Tennessee last week in a game that was actually closer than the score. And this week they gave the BYU people all they wanted before they finally gave in by a point. John Kearney, and he's got another long one. Colasar's going to come out of there with it. And he gets it out across the 20 to about the 22. And it looked like John might have made a mistake as he hesitated for a moment before he came 3 yards out of the end zone. Digger Phelps just walked by, and those of you who follow Notre Dame basketball, David Rivers says he's going to be back on the court and ready to go, what, by November, Digger?
November 1st is going. I think it'll be a little longer, maybe another 2 weeks.
Good to see you, Coach.
Good to see you, Coach.
Had a lot of fun with Digger working the Olympic basketball games in Los Angeles in 84. The ball is at the 21 now. First down for the Wolverines. Harbaugh lines up at quarterback with White and Jamie Morris in the eye behind him. Kolasar and Jokic, the deep people. Jamie Morris with the ball coming right up the middle. And he takes it up to about the 26, maybe the 27-yard line. Individual stats at halftime. You see, Berline had a pretty good first half. It was his leadership, I thought, as much as anything, more than the numbers that he's put on the board. And I thought Green and Brown were really outstanding. The Michigan defense leading tackler Mester. And there's been one turnover in the ball game. That a fumble by Reggie Ward that Michigan recovered. Colasar goes in motion on second down and 4. Ball goes back to Morris again, and Jamie's got the first down as he pounds through the middle, and they're finding some daylight on the right side. Kovaleski making his 13th tackle of the ball game.
Well, we told you he's been moving all around. This time he's not in the line of scrimmage. He's sitting back, but see his reaction time? No false steps. Right away he goes to the left, goes to the distance of the ball, gets rid of that one blocker, and makes a tackle. Morris is pretty quick, though. He's got those quick feet. We talked about those fast switch muscle fibers last week. He's got them.
First down for the Wolverines. Put the ball at the 33. Harbaugh rolls it out. Climbs after it. Gets some help. Downfield. Pass caught. Jokic down at the Irish 40. First down, Michigan. Randy Wells shoved him out of bounds. So Jokic finally sees the ball for the first time today.
Jokic is deceptive. You watch him on films, you watch him at practice, he's got those long strides, doesn't look like he's that fast, but he's got tremendous speed and deception. That time they utilized him, got him back amongst the smaller defensive backs, and he threw it high and he made the catch. Basketball player, played his first 2 years on the basketball team.
From the 40 of the Irish. Morris slips and falls right about the line of scrimmage, maybe a half yard or so.
I think Wally Klein scared him to death. Wally Klein has a little
ball to Jokic.
Come on, baby.
Harbaugh back again. Gets his pass away to the sidelines, and I don't think Jokic ever saw it. He looked back into the sun. Now, looking back from that angle is very, very difficult in the stadium because you're staring right into the sun, and I don't think he ever picked up the ball.
You made that point in the first half, and it cost Notre Dame a field goal, so it must be a factor down here. But watch this. As Jokic runs a sideline and up pattern, the ball's right there. He looks back, but Steve Lawrence, the defensive back, it hit his right hand. He never looked over his shoulder. When that receiver looks back, and that defender also has to know the ball's in the area, and he has to adjust and go up and reach it at its highest point.
So it's third down and 10. Now you get three wideouts in the ball game for Michigan. Ken Higgins, number 31, the third wideout. Banks is after him. Harbaugh runs away from it. Now gets it off to White. White's got a first down and then some as he dives to the 20. First down, Wolverines. The mobility of Harbaugh, the discipline of Harbaugh, the patience the young man has is quite remarkable.
If there's not a play available, then he will invent something. Now you watch what happens here. He drops back and looks at every possible receiver. Now he goes to the left. All right, now here when he runs, he puts pressure on the corner. See Kovaleski, he's got to commit himself and come up. And once he does, he leaves the flat open. And there, of course, is White. He's the receiver.
So Michigan moving the ball here at start of the second half. Just beginning. Harbaugh gives it to Morris. Morris finds some room, and he's close to the 15 before he is thrown down. Kovaleski leading the defensive play for Notre Dame. Greg McMurtry, a freshman from Brockton, Massachusetts, who turned down a Boston Red Sox bid for baseball, is now in the lineup. He's a big youngster, 6'3", 200, and very fast. He's coming wide to the bottom of your picture now, along with Higgins. And it's second down and about 5.5. Harbaugh running away from the pressure, running for his life, and will not get back to the line of scrimmage. That time, run down by Brandy Wells, number 5.
Tremendous pursuit. He wanted to get onto that corner to that young McMurtry. Now, they gave McMurtry number 1. He looks a lot like Anthony Carter. He runs like AC. And
he's bigger.
You mentioned that the Bo Sox made him their number 1 draft pick, offered him $250,000, and he came to get his education. You know, Maryland had a situation like that. Willie Wilson signed with the University of Maryland several years back. Then he opted to play baseball with the Royals and had a brilliant baseball career.
Vitale comes over the ball at center for Michigan now on third down and 7. The ball back at the 17. Harbaugh fires. Got a man at the 6-yard line. Higgins, and it's first and goal, Michigan. So Higgins makes his first catch. He's a senior, 190-pounder out of Battle Creek, Michigan.
Harbaugh, his dad is a head football coach. Grew up in the locker room at the University of Michigan when his dad was an assistant for Bo Schembechler. There's nothing fancy about this. The receiver just drives the defensive back off. And Ken Higgins plants and comes back for the football, which you always have to come back for that football and make the catch.
Actually, he played most of his high school ball at Palo Alto, California when Jack was out at Stanford.
That's right. As a little kid, though, he was here in Michigan.
Oh, yeah. It's first and goal from the 6 for the Wolverines. Out of that wishbone, they go inside to the big man, Perryman, and Perryman pounds along, and the linesman has marked him down at the 1. That linesman is marking with the left foot. The fellow we watched last week at Nebraska marked all day with his right foot.
You know, the officials, they're great guys. They do a tremendous job, but marking the football is shaky, I'm telling you.
All you defensive backs are like that. Arbitrary.
Jamie Morris is out, and Thomas Wilshire is now in the backfield for Michigan, number 27. Harbaugh gives it to the second man, White, and White is held short of Noah Perryman, short of the goal line. I thought the second man, White, got it, but it was Perryman. And so it is third down and goal, and it is a half a yard.
We've talked about the size of that Michigan offensive line. Let's give some credit to Notre Dame. That goal line defense that time, those down linemen got down and submarined. They established a new line of scrimmage a yard deep in the backfield, and the linebackers filled.
Now who goes over the top? Harbaugh outside, Morris, foot race to the corner, he's in there, touchdown. Cedric Figueroa just simply didn't have the speed to match Morris once Jamie got outside.
Comes back to the contain man again. Look at the top of your screen right now. All right, they get in Harbaugh's face quickly, but nobody's scraping off to come upfield and make that play. Now here comes Figueroa. Cedric Figueroa got over there, but he should have been across that line of scrimmage and scraped off quicker.
Easy for you to say.
Well, that's exactly right. That's a tough play, and I guarantee you, I watch guys run by me a lot. I had my head on a swivel.
Moons for the extra point. Pat pops it high in the air and good. At 8 minutes and 57 seconds to go in the third quarter, Michigan back on top, 17 to 14. Sutkiewicz will hit it from the 35. Michigan leading 17-14, and it's a very short kick. It's going to bounce around and bounce back upfield. Michigan's got it. It hit another day, man. Michigan's got it. Doug Mallory, I think, is the man that came down and drove on the football. So a big break in the game. Notre Dame on that short kick. They kind of went to sleep on it, actually. The man just simply did not come up and make the play. It's Aaron Robb letting the ball bounce in front of him. Probably the last thing in the world that Aaron expected. You see it bounce off number 88, Andy Heck. And there's Doug Mallory to pounce on it. And the Michigan Wolverines are in business at the Notre Dame 27-yard line.
Interesting shot, though. When they came off the field, Lou Holtz calmly walked over and explained to him the error. You can't let the ball hit the ground. Andy Heck, of course, has to locate the ball before he can throw a block. Miscue. Could cost him.
Clock never moved on it. He's still got 8:57 to go in the third quarter, and Harbaugh now looks to cash in. He's got a man going into the corner. Touchdown, Morris. Oh, yeah, he got it. Yes. Ball came loose. He hit the ground. It's a touchdown.
Football team. We'll find out how they react. We told you they were a porous defense last year, gave up more passing yards, more touchdowns than any other Notre Dame team. Now they're facing adversity. These kids have to just buckle up and come back and play.
He had it when he went down, and it's called a touchdown. Rightly so. Here's the extra point try by Pat Moons. It is good. So they have scored 14 points in 6 seconds.
And everybody in this stadium has to be wondering now if this Notre Dame team will fold like it did in the game against Miami last year, or whether they now have character. Here it is again. Now, Harbaugh, of course, just it's play action. He drops. He had a man across the middle who was wide open, number 80, Jeffrey Brown, his tight end. You see him there in the middle, wandering down the seam. But instead, he goes to the outside. Not bad coverage, but it's also a brilliant catch by Jamie Morris. He's playing a good game. We saw him run. Now we see him receive. Just took that outside guy. The defender was in his hip pocket. He made the catch.
The measure.
So you do it.
All right, here comes the Irish now. Sass comes back with it. A flanker. Remember, no, it's Ward. Reggie Ward, 83, comes back upfield with it. And a good determined run by Reggie Ward as he bolts out across the 35 to the 34-yard line. I would imagine that Reggie feels he's got something left to prove because he had the fumble in the first half.
Let me say something, though, Keith. You know, that Lou Holtz is a competitor, and I don't care how much he jokes, and he is a funny guy, and he is the master of motivation, but he is a competitor, and he loves these kids to death. I talked about character. This is a totally different team than we had last year against Miami. This is a totally different team that had those losses last year. They'll come back. This team's going to improve from quarter to quarter.
First down, ball is on the Irish 34-yard line, 24 to 14, as Michigan scored 14 points in 6 seconds. And Berline throws underneath to the tight end, Joel Williams, a senior from Monroeville, Pennsylvania. And he goes for a first down up at the 46. And now let's go back to Al Troutwig to finish the story.
Well, Keith, I'm beginning to think I better let Reverend James really get back on the sidelines. He's been the team chaplain for 20 years.
Kimmy Brown comes to the bottom of the picture now. Second down, 7 yards to go. Berline drops. Steve looks downfield, has time, goes out of bounds with it to Alvin Miller. Incomplete forward pass. So that will come back now, and they'll be looking at third and long at 7:41 to go in the third quarter and trailing by 10 points. Notre Dame on third down conversion attempts in the ball game, 6 for 6.
Big zero on the right hand side there is important to Steve Berline.
Got it again. Miller makes the catch. And he is at the Michigan 37.
Lou Holtz shuttles his plays in and out. Now, he saw a two-deep zone from Michigan last time. We've told you the way to attack that is across the middle. So he came right back with the receiver, Alvin Miller, number 17, across the middle. See, they come up and they bump him. Now you get back into the zone part, the two-deep zone. And there it is, wide open across the middle. You got to get help from that linebacker back there, and the safety has to come over and assist as well.
Miller is out, and Milt Jackson is in at the wide receiver spot. And looks like Alvin took a shot. He's carried a kind of a bad leg for two seasons. Berline rides it off to his fullback. And Pernell Taylor, who hasn't seen the ball a whole lot today, he's been primarily a blocking back. And he slams in there and gets good yardage on that carry. About four.
This is a drive that answered any question.
Six. Tailback Mark Green to about the 31, picked up two. Number 60, Mark Messner, almost nailed him solid. He just got a piece of him. But Messner was the leading tackler for Michigan, the defensive tackle, 60. Third down and four. Berline keeps it, fights for the marker, and Mark Green was the man that covered it. I sort of lost the ball in the melee.
He picked it up, and
Green picked it up.
Berline makes a good read on this. See him fake to the dive man, and now everybody's outside, so things are loose. He turns it up, knows what he needs for the first down, but see, the ball's loose, and it was loose before he hit the ground. Mark Green, the pitch man, very alertly came back, picked it up, and dove forward.
What about the old rule about you can't advance a fumble?
To the 28-yard line, but that was going to be my point. Very smart move. What? Pick it up and just lunge. Okay? But you can't advance the fumble. That's against the rules.
Well, why doesn't somebody else? Berline, behind his offensive line, will have the first down. Just about the Michigan 26-yard line. I can see Dave Nelson mumbling right now. First down for the Irish at the Michigan 26. 5:15 to go, third quarter. 24-14, Michigan leads by 10. This is Tim Brown. inside the 15 to the 14. That's another Notre Dame first down.
Notre Dame went back to the short side of the field, hit that corner quickly. 24, Mark Green helped that guy right there. Number 81, Tim Brown, get around that corner now. Green didn't throw a physical block, but he got in the way and just tied up the defensive back with that corner when Green turned it inside.
That's 16 first downs for the Irish. They go to the wishbone. Mark Green, penalty flag, 1 yard for Green. That might be a hold on the offense. Against Michigan. Green. Remember, he's 220 pounds. He carried it one time in the first half and had a big play. There's contact made by number 56, Billy Harris, on the center, Chuck Lanza.
Bo Schembechler is livid.
Don't blame him. Mistakes like that will get you beat. John Nealon takes the football down to the four. Got Brown in motion. Pitch it to Johnson. Down at the line of scrimmage. May not have reached the line of scrimmage. Looks like the linesman's going to mark him on about the 1 yard line as Andy Moeller came flying in to make the hit from the linebacker spot. Green went comes back with the play now.
They went after the corner, but the contain man on the outside turned it back in, and then he had to fight his way right back into the pursuit.
I say one, make it five, 5 yard line. So they need now about a yard and a half on second down for their first down. Ball resting just outside the five. 3.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. This is Tim Brown. He dives and looks like he's got his first down. Brown looks like he's been playing running back all of his life, doesn't he? Brown comes out now and Reggie Ward goes in. You're now in four down, certainly four down country, with first down and goal from the three. Berline, little lob, touchdown, Joe Williams.
I pulled Carl yesterday and pulled the key away. Carl holds no fears for me. I have found today. They're back. This is a play taken out of the Michigan textbook. Fake run and just push pass. Wide open. Everybody committed to the line of scrimmage.
Carney's extra point. No good. Missed it. Missed the extra point. 24-20. Big difference. Big difference. 3 minutes and 10 seconds to play in the third quarter. Here it is. Hole was good. The snap was good. Carney just hooked it outside. He has not been really sharp. He had 3 kicks blocked late last year. He made only 1 field goal in the last 5 games. 21 out of 24 extra points. But there's a lot of difference between 24-20 and 24-21. Jamie Morris and John Colasar waiting for Carney's kickoff. He hasn't let anybody return one all day. Well, he did, too. They ran one out of the end zone to start the half, but this time Colasar thinks better of it because he's about 6 yards deep in the end zone, and he stays there. And so Michigan will come out to the 20, first down. 24-20 ball game. But I think, to go back to a point you made a little while ago, Tim, that Lou Holtz got to be happy, the whole coaching staff got to be happy to see their team come banging right back after Michigan had stunned them with 14 points. First down from the 20. Harbaugh gives to Morris, and Jamie Morris from the 20 to the 24.
All right, here's that play we just talked about. Now, we've got the rule out, and it's right here in front of me on page 77. Here comes Berline. Berline turns it up. And now when he fumbles it, if Michigan recovered it, it'd be dead right there, and it'd be Michigan's fall. But Green picks it up. The play continues. Article 2, Section C, Davey Nelson.
Second down and six. 2.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Perriman's in the backfield now, and Morris is out. So it's Perriman and White. Harbaugh rolls it out, gets his pass away, intended for Perriman, and it is incomplete. Perriman bolting out of the backfield, covered by Randy Wells, and the pass was just simply thrown beyond the reach of both men. Harbaugh, 11 completions for 10 first downs and a touchdown, so he has been very effective in the game, and that well may have been the worst pass he's thrown all day.
That play was made, though, by the defense. Robert Banks and old Tom Gordon, the defensive tackle, got into him in a hurry, put pressure on him, and he had to rush the throw.
Third down now for Michigan and six. Pretty good size play right here for the Wolverines and Ole Miss. Harbaugh's pass is away and short of Higgins, the intended receiver, and they'll have to punt.
Boy, I tell you, that Notre Dame defense is strapping it on now. That time Mike Griffin, big number 94, came through and applied the pressure. Made him hurry the throw again.
Monty Robbins has punted one time today for 23 yards. Troy Wilson is the deep man for Notre Dame. No pressure. And he still didn't get all of it. Wilson comes up and accepts it and takes the punishment, but he's got good field position with it. It'll be first down, Notre Dame at their own 47. That a 31-yard punt. This edge goes to Harbaugh. He has a 24-20 lead right now, but Steve Berline has the ball. First down at the Irish 47. And he's throwing on first down, swings it out to Green, two big blockers in front of him, and he's on his way. All the way to the 25. A 28-yard play. They'll call it 29 because they give him almost the 24.
The play is set up beautifully. They fake to the back. They get it out. Now here come all the linemen. They pulled and got out there quickly. Now there's the difference in team speed from the time Lou Holtz got here until now. He's had them work on weights to get stronger. He's tried to improve their speed. They got out in front of him. This kid can run. It looks like he's been there all his life. He was an outstanding running back in high school.
Back to the wishbone go the Irish. And they go to Tim Brown up the middle to the 21. That's 3 yards. Berline pretty much owns the passing record. He's now passed Joe Theismann to take the all-time yardage leadership. Away from Theismann, he leads in percentage. So he's well into the Notre Dame record book now. Senior quarterback on second down and six. Fumble. Michigan's ball. Parnell Taylor, in a wrestling match at the line of scrimmage, loses the football, and Doug Mallory comes up with his second recovery of the day. Third turnover.
play, got good blocking. There's the lick. And all of a sudden, second effort, and the ball comes out when the right hand of the ref knocks it loose. You can see it coming. That's Garland Rivers. We talked about him in the pregame. He's a hard hitter. That time, not so much the leverage that he had. It was the right arm that swung around up underneath the ball.
And Ann Arbor, more than 100,000 watching a tough defensive struggle. Late in the game, Michigan place kicker Brian Virgil with a chance to win the game for Michigan with a field goal. But Irish linebacker Bob Crable climbed the stack and blocked the kick, and Notre Dame won 12-10. Crable's space flight, incidentally, with a little help from the back of his friends, helped stimulate refinement of the rules on such plays. You can no longer run up the back of your colleagues to block a kick. Garland Rivers, cornerback, forcing the third Notre Dame turnover. Doug Mallory making his second recovery of the day, and the Michigan Wolverines take over just outside their 15-yard line. Hammered that right hand in there, and ball squirted out. And here comes Michigan now, with a minute to go in the third quarter. Michigan leading 24-20. Harbaugh on first down, the pass. Swings it out to Jamie Morris, and Morris is run down by Cedric Figueroa. Cedric been chasing him all day out there in the corner and finally got it.
Well, I tell you, he saw that play coming, too. He came across the line of scrimmage and stopped just long enough to think, to make Harbaugh think that he was going to be out there to contain him and put pressure on him. As soon as Harbaugh saw that, pulled up and released the ball and got it outside. Well, he broke on the football immediately and got over there and made the tackle.
It's been a fist fight up to this point. Michigan now second down, a loss on that play of three. Second and 13. Jamie Morris picks his way through to the 20. So that'll go down as a 6-yard run for Jamie Morris. And the third quarter is over. 24-20, Wolverines lead the Fighting Irish. CFA College football continues after this message and a word from our local station. Here. Jokic has caught only one ball today. That was a 27-yard gain. Kolasar's not in. It is McMurtry in at the flanker spot. McMurtry and Kolas and Jokic go wide to the top of the picture. Pass down the middle, and it is to Jokic, and it is good for a first down up at the 31-yard line. That time the big guy rolled into it and took it sliding down.
Very big play. Notre Dame wanted to stop him there after the turnover and get the ball right back to the offense. Notre Dame was aggressive defensively. They rolled up the strong safety and put him in close from the tight end. Instead, they went to Jokic, and they just, you're right, they brought him right across that middle underneath the coverage.
Gerald White becomes the tailback as Morris leaves. Berryman comes in at fullback for Michigan. First down at the near the 32, and White tries to find a little daylight. Not much there as Tom Gorman brings him down, and Dave Butler, number 37, a linebacker, had stepped into the backfield and messed up the play.
As the quarter ended and we began this fourth quarter, the teams took their stroll down to change sides. Everybody on the Notre Dame sideline, all the players put up their right hand with the number four, four fingers high in the air, signifying that, hey, we may have been weak in the past in the fourth quarter, but now the fourth quarter is going to be ours. It's something that Lou Holtz instigated as soon as he came here to Notre Dame. He wants them to be stronger in the fourth quarter, but Michigan can wear you down.
Second down and still about 10. Harbaugh back to throw the ball. Goes deep down the middle for Higgins, and it's too long.
Well, it's highlighted for you. That's the difference right now. No turnovers for Michigan, three turnovers for Notre Dame. Everything else is evened out quite nicely. It's been a close ball game, but those three turnovers have hurt the Irish badly.
13 minutes and 46 seconds to play in the football game. Michigan leading 24-20. Morris is back now in the backfield with Perryman. Third down and still about 10 from the 32. Harbaugh gives to Morris. And Jamie is swarmed at the 34. So it'll be punting time for Money Robbins.
Notre Dame.
But he's keyed things very well. Troy Wilson, the return man. This time Robbins hits one. Wilson at the 25 to about the 27, 40-yard punt. And Doug Mallory made the tackle at 12 minutes and 59 seconds to play in the football game. The Irish trailing the Wolverines by 4.
Keith?
Shocking score, 40-7, Washington leading. So after UCLA got pummeled last week by Oklahoma, and now Washington opens so big against Ohio State, folks out on the West Coast might be singing a little different line right now, huh? USC opens tonight against Illinois. It's first down as Steve Berline rolls it out, pumps it, now looks down the middle. He's got Brown wide open. The Michigan 41.
Well, I tell you, Berline could be the most improved quarterback I've ever seen. He pumps to the outside, comes back across the middle. Now here he comes. There's Tim Brown just drifting across the middle. He got lost in the coverage. Puts a little juke move on and gets out to the side. Now it's just a race, foot race. One big difference that we've seen in Notre Dame this year is that they've rushed the ball 152 yards, passed for 153, 9 first downs both ways, running and passing. We didn't see that last year.
Tim Brown has come out dragging a leg. Berline hit from behind as he throws the ball, but still gets it to Reggie Ward. And Ward is down to the Michigan 25. Another first down. Mallory and Arnold were down there to get him, but Mallory is down hurt on the play. Watch Berline get clobbered here.
He is just playing with confidence, though, Keith. He sees the defenders coming. He knows he's going to take a lick and still releases the ball quickly. He got it up, threw it right off his ear, and got it out to the wide-open receiver.
And time is out now for Doug Mallory, shaken up.
Than any other school in the nation.
Doug Mallory being helped to the bench. It looks like left leg.
Well, here it is again. You can see him coming in and converging on Timmy Brown. He wraps him up good. Now watch his own player. Hits him right there in the knee, and you see the knee hyperextend. We hope it's not serious. It was just aggressiveness on both sides. That left knee was, or the left leg was locked into the ground when his own man hit him just above that knee.
Right now, Notre Dame knocking on the door. First down at the Michigan 25-yard line with 12 and a half minutes to play in the game. Berline to Green. And Green over the top to the 20. Him checking the knee of Mallory. Tim Brown apparently just a mild sprain. He's said to be all right, and he's back in the lineup. Second down, call it 5. This is Brown. Hits the chalk down around the 13-yard line. Make it the 12. That will be another Irish first down. A lot of time to go, 11:44, but this may be building one of the major, major stories of the season.
You said of the decade.
Well, that's right. It wouldn't go down in my top 10.
You know, Notre Dame is just having fun now. They're playing with fun and a great deal of confidence. Yep.
This is Green, and Green hit by Mallory hard. A molar, rather. Molar. And Andy Molar knocks him sideways. There'll be no gain on the play. Green has 56 yards on 13 carries and a touchdown today. Now Tom Monahan, a senior fullback, comes into the lineup replacing Cornell Taylor. You haven't seen a lot of Frank Stams today because Frank's just getting over leg injury. Wishbone for the Irish. Call it second down and 9. Berline rolls it out. Looks to the end zone. Nobody there. He was looking for Andy Heck, and the Michigan defensive people had taken him away because Rivers and Gant were all over him, and Berline, rather than risk it, pulled it down and stepped out of bounds at the 8.
Berline is showing a great deal of leadership right now. After a good play, he's the first one over to congratulate the player who ran the ball or caught the pass. He's showing a great deal of composure as well.
Taylor is back in at fullback now. He's been the blocking back today. It's third down and 6 from the 8. Berline loops it to the corner for Tim Brown. Intercepted in the corner by David Arnold. It'll come out to the 20. That is the 4th turnover for Notre Dame.
It is the first interception that Berline has thrown. Now, we talked about the problems he's had in his career in the past. 37 interceptions, now 38. In his career, more interceptions than he's thrown touchdown passes here at Notre Dame. That pass should not have been thrown. He was throwing it a good 45 yards across the field. It was supposed to be a timing pattern, just get it out in front of the receiver, but the defensive back had it all the way.
And the coaching goes on the sidelines as Michigan dodges a bullet and takes the ball first down at the 20 with 10 minutes and 50 seconds to play in the game. Jamie Morris and Bob Perryman in the backfield for the Wolverines. Kolasar in motion. And Harbaugh gives it to Jamie Morris. And Jamie Morris finds some daylight out to about the 28.
Boy, that tells a story, doesn't it?
Sure. But turnovers, like injuries, are part of the game.
You look at Notre Dame's game against Michigan up in Ann Arbor last year, and it was a fight for the life up there. Yep. Notre Dame played well, but turned the ball over, got in close, and couldn't score.
Second down, 2. Perryman, the fullback. He will not get the first down. He had to come to the 30. And he did not get it. Next Saturday, next week, we'll check your local listings for CFA football next Saturday on third down, 1.5 yards for Michigan. Into the middle, and they've got the first down, as this time Bob Perryman was able to square shoulders and get his legs under him and drove it out to the 32. Injury, Al Trautwig.
Well, Keith, I just checked in with senior Doug Mallory. He's got a big pile of ice on that knee. I checked with the team doctor. They said they're not quite sure. They'll wait till after the game to give it a closer look. But right now, he sits on the sidelines and watches his Michigan team.
On first down, Harbaugh throws it out of bounds. Threw it away, and Lou Holtz is screaming for... Well, actually, in strident tones, he's conversing for a grounding call, but he unloaded that ball rather than wind up on his ear with Cedric Figueroa all over him.
I'll tell you what I'd be yelling about. Watch number 48. Cedric Figueroa now will come across the line of scrimmage. Now look at the left hand there of the Michigan guy. He's holding his eight.
Holding, yeah.
He's pulling him right back. That's what I'd be yelling about.
Maybe that's what he was yelling about. Anyway, it's second down and 10. Gerald White is now the tailback with Morris out. Start thinking Jokic here. He's available, but they throw it underneath to White, the tailback. And White is at the 36-yard line. That's a pickup of about 4 yards. It'll be third down and long, and Jokic was available.
Harbaugh's just smart. You know that? He'll throw it away if nobody's covered. He won't take the sack. He very rarely turns the ball over, as evidenced by leading the nation in his passing efficiency. Throws very few touchdowns, or interceptions, rather. 124 passes without an interception coming into this game, and he has yet to throw one here. Gets a lot of that from his dad, I guess, his head coach at Western Michigan.
Third and 6. Jokic on the sidelines. The pass was broken up. Troy Wilson, number 12, was right there. The ball was late getting there. And Jokic that time was not available and couldn't make the catch because Wilson was all over him, and now Michigan has to punt.
Here's Troy Wilson now. He gets into his back pedal. The ball on the break. Cuts in front of the receivers, reading the ball all the way. Now last ditch effort, that left hand just slaps it away. Great defensive play.
Marty Robbins, third punt, 23-31. Last one went for 40. And Wilson, who just made the play, is the man Notre Dame likes to have return it. He does not get the ball to turn over again. This is fielded by Reggie Ward, and Reggie Ward is collected in a very harsh manner. I didn't get the Michigan man's number. A 34-yard punt, very high. Was it Perryman that hit him?
Watch Perryman come into your screen now. No fair catch signal, so he knows as soon as that ball touches, he's open game.
Here's
just
Perryman.
Tucks that tail and puts that Rydell right under his helmet. There is not a better tackler on that team. He just tucks that tail, gets all the leverage behind him, and packs a punch. Football team, and you can see that they have improved fundamentally. The defense is a lot sounder, and the offense is well-balanced and deceptive.
The pressure right now is on the Michigan defense as the Irish start out first down at their own 29, trailing 24-20. And throwing on first down. Down the middle it goes to the tight end, Joel Williams. And the big end gets up across the 40, near the 42 for a first down. And again, poised by Berline.
You have to like the call. Berline throws an interception that stops what could have been a touchdown drive. At least it was threatening. So what does he do? He comes right back with a pass. Puts him right back on the saddle of the horse that threw it. Says, hey, let's build this kid's confidence back up. He hung in there until the last second and completed a beautiful pass.
Call it the 41. Pickup of 12, first down Irish. Down the middle it goes, same man. It's Andy Heck this time, the tight end. And it's Heck who comes down with it for a short gain of about 3 as Todd Schulte hit him and held him. Brought him right down. And time becomes a factor now as we hit the 7-minute mark to go in the ball game. 24-20 here in South Bend, Michigan. Upsets around the country today, some surprises around the country by the lopsided scores. From the 44 now. Ward is in. Brown is out. That flanker for Notre Dame. Little loop out here to Mark Green. Two blockers in front of him, and Green is on his way. Knocked out of bounds inside the 30. On again, finally knocked him out of bounds, and Green running well in traffic.
Once again, Berline sets it up. Play fake inside to Pernell Taylor. And get it out. Here's the screen now. Everybody's pulling. You see big number 72, John Askin out there got a block. 65 gets a block. Gets Tom Freeman. And you know, the guy who he faked it to, Pernell Taylor, got out there and got a block.
He's been a good blocking back all day. They ruled that Green hit the chalk, the sidelines, at the 35-yard line, and that's where it is, first down. Reverse with Brown carrying, and Brown, with help coming around the corner, is thrown down at the 20. That's a pickup of 15 yards and another Notre Dame touchdown, and the Irish are rolling up and down the field.
I'm telling you, Michigan right now doesn't know which way it's coming from. They run the reverse. There's nobody home out here for containment. Everybody had followed the ball. By the time they turn around, the pulling guards in front of the ball carrier, this time it's Brown, and Brown picks up another Irish first down.
Tell you what, Notre Dame had turned it over four times. They'd be sitting on a big lead already, wouldn't they?
You're right.
First down from the 20, Berline gives the ball to Taylor. And Pernell Taylor, who's been blocking for everybody else all day, gets his second or third carry of the ball game. And he picks up 2 yards.
Okay, now they're rapidly approaching the area of mental block. This is where they've gotten several times and walked away without any points. They can't do that this time. We've got 5:40 remaining in the ballgame. They trail Michigan by 4 points. They need the touchdown badly. They have to execute, and they know it.
Michigan defense being bumped around some here in this fourth quarter. Berline back. Whistles his pass. Pass is caught by Green. Green breaks one tackle, and he's just short of the 10. Andy Moeller is over there to get him.
Michigan's not getting the pressure up front, Keith. Berline's having time to set. That time Michigan was in his own defense. Green just hooked up. When he planted and turned, the ball was there on the button hook. He's a little bit winded.
And very little penetration by the Michigan front defense.
It was that time. They didn't get across the neutral zone.
Green and Brown have combined for 231 yards today. Pass and run. Braxton Banks is in there now at the halfback position. And he's got the ball. Braxton Banks, a 210-pound freshman from Hayward, California, into the game for the first time and gets the ball.
And the first down.
And the first down. It is first and goal, Notre Dame. The ball just short of the Michigan 6.
This whole stadium is rocking now. You can just feel the intensity, the electricity.
Short of the line of scrimmage. Number 15, David Arnold, who had an interception in the end zone. The last time Notre Dame was down here, led that defensive charge to take Ward down back on the 8-yard line. It is second down and goal. Berline throwing for Brown. Rucker. Tough catch. He was looking over his right shoulder and then tried to flip back to the left side, shielding the defender Arnold away with his body, and the ball dropped right off his arm.
Same call, other side, that they had intercepted just a few minutes ago. It's a timing pattern. He throws it out there into the corner, wants Brown to run up under it. Brown made the turn, was a difficult catch, hit his hands. He knows it hit his hands. And they tell you, your receiving coach, anytime it even gets close like that, you have got to have it.
Third down and goal. It'll be interesting to see what they do if they have to look at fourth and goal from the 8. The extra point looming, looming, and looming. The missed extra point. Mark Green is back in. Berline rolls it left. Throws into the end zone. Touchdown!
Oh, they said he was out.
Out of bounds.
I want to see.
He came down right down on the line. Now, I don't know. Nobody's called touchdown. I called it too soon. They are saying no pass. Incomplete. His foot hit the chalk. It's Joel Williams, number 89. Watch for the number.
Oh, was that close? I can't wait to see it. Now, Berline had all the time in the world. It's a tough throw now. He's got to turn his body and square his shoulders, but he drills it right in there. Watch his feet.
Official is right there. Couldn't miss the call. He's looking right at the feet. It's got to be a good call. Got to be a good call because he's looking right at his feet 2 yards from him. Carney's in for a field goal try. And he hits it. And it's a one-point ball game from 25 yards out. John Carney, who had missed the extra point, now hits a 25-yard field goal. And with 4 minutes and 26 seconds to play in the ball game, it's a one-pointer. It was ruled no catch, out of bounds. They kicked the field goal, and now it's a one-pointer. Obviously, they feel they can hold Michigan and get the ball back. It is now pressure time on the Michigan offense. 4:26 to play in the game. 24-23, Michigan. Carney to kick off. Danny Morris at the one. Short of the 20. Good coverage downfield. Back to about the 17 where Tom Byrne brings him down. And here's the play in which a touchdown was just missed.
Perfect execution until the receiver hits the ground. It is still so close. And yet the receiver is right. I mean, the referee, the official, the back judge is right there. Watch this. See, the defender comes right in front of the picture, so you can't tell. Oh, that's close.
Got to be a good call. The man's looking right at his feet. The official. Just outside the 17. First down. White and Morris out of the eye. Morris on a sweep. Out to the 20. Did he fumble? He fumbled the football. But was he down? Three officials are talking. He was down. Whoa. Everything is marginal right here, isn't it? So close. Down. No question. Down.
Excellent call. Excellent call. See, he had the ball when he hit the ground. That's exactly right. It's Michigan's ball should be.
Second down. About eight. White and Perryman out of the eye now. They may have to throw the ball here. You got to think Jokic when you think pass at this point. They give it a White, and that's 2 yards at the most before Robert Banks cuts him down. Now they almost surely will have to put it up. Olisar, Higgins, and Jokic, the wide receivers. Going big for Olisar. He's out there. He's got it. And he's out of bounds at the Notre Dame 40. He got by and outran Marv Spence, the right cornerback, 38-yard play.
Nothing fancy about it. Harbaugh comes back and just unloads. Marv Spence has man-to-man coverage. And you mentioned at the very top of the show that Kolzar is a flyer. Well, he did at that time. It was just a foot race and outraced him down the sidelines. And the most important thing is he made the catch. First down, Michigan. Notre Dame territory with 2:36 left.
Oh, what a big play that was, huh? Simple play, but big. 24-23 ball game, Michigan by one. White and Perryman, the backs. That's Perryman, 225-pounder, jams in there for about three. Both teams have three timeouts remaining. Third quarter, John Carney missed this extra point. Otherwise, we'd be in a tie.
Kicker's like a golfer. He's got to have a good rhythm. He's got to make good contact, and he can't think a whole lot about it once he's over top of it.
The loneliest position on the team, too.
Except for Mars Spence.
Yep. Right now, yeah. Second down, call it six. White looking around for a place to run and can't find anything as number 94, Mike Griffin, jumps on him, and again the ball was rolling around on the ground. The ball carrier was down. Now, Notre Dame is going to spend a timeout. They'll have two remaining. That stops your clock at 1 minute and 43 seconds to play in the ball game. And it has been a dandy. It down the middle. That's got to be interference. Got to be. Jokic is tackled before the ball got there by Steve Lawrence. And that will give him a first down.
Well, some of the defenders are arguing the point, but it's a moot point because it's a good call. Now, you'll see, Harbaugh releases this ball. Here comes Jokic across the middle. Now, it is good coverage out there. There's no question about that. But Steve Lawrence does climb on his back too early.
The ball is put at the 29-yard line. First down.
Cannot make contact until that ball is there. He just got a little bit anxious, knew he was in good position, tried to put that left hand out in front, and what he did, the right side of his body hit Jokic in the back.
First down, Michigan, minute 39 to play. They work out of the wishbone and go to the up man, Perryman, the fullback. Again, Notre Dame is shouting for the ball.
That one did look like a fumble.
They're unwrapping him. It was a fumble. Number 34, Wes Pritchett, junior out of Atlanta, Georgia, comes out of there with it. With a minute and 33 seconds to play in the ball game. So Michigan makes its first mistake of the afternoon. First turnover for the Wolverines. That was a fumble, and the Irish outfought them for it. And they have it first down at their own 26-yard line. Now, tradition, legend, ghosts of the past, all those things, they're not playing. But Notre Dame has owned this fourth quarter against Michigan, and Berline back to throw on first down. Down the middle goes for Miller. Miller is down to the Michigan 40. First down, Irish.
Riverboat gambler came out, no hesitation, there, threw over the linebackers. Alvin Miller is 6'4". He threw it high. It had to be high enough to get over the linebacker and under the safety. And it was a perfectly thrown ball.
It looked like Dieter Heron might have gotten a piece of it. They put it at the 41 of Michigan with a minute and 15 to play in the ball game. And Berline back on first down, whips it out to Mark Green. He put his knee on the ground back at the 46, and that's where the ball will be put. A loss of 5 yards. And timeout called by the Irish to stop the clock with 1:06 to play in the ball game. They have one left. 46-yard line. The Wolverines leading by a point. Irish with one timeout remaining and 1 minute and 6 seconds to play in the ball game. Jackson and Brown come wide to the bottom of the picture, and Berline's back to throw, and still very little defensive pressure, and thrown down the middle and caught by Jackson at the 29-yard line, and he's down there. First down for Notre Dame. The clock shows a minute, stopping while they move the chains. They have one timeout remaining. They're getting close enough now for John Carney to be put into a posture of redemption.
If they kick right now, Keith, it'd be a 40-yarder. He's 15 of 16 from 40 yards or more.
Tight end moved forward, straight ahead. Concentration broke a little bit on Joel Williams. Tight end can move, can flex, but you can't go straight ahead.
See, now, as long as we're thinking about Carney, that takes him into a danger zone. I said he's 15 to 16 between the 40 and 49.
That'd be 52 yards.
Yeah, once you get past the 50 now, he's only 5 of 11, and his longest is 51 yards, and that was in the Aloha Bowl in 84.
All start, Notre Dame, still first down.
First and 15 as the ball comes back to the 35. ...46 seconds to play in the game. Berline, quick pop, sideline, Jackson drops it. Pass was low, and Milt looking to see where he could go with it. Really didn't look it all the way home, and it sort of rolled off his fingertips on the grass.
Boy, Berline knew it. As soon as he released the pass, he grabbed his helmet and said, oh, no, he was wide open, I just threw it into the dirt. You know, it's worked well for him today, is that screen.
Yep, certainly has. Brown is out right now. Tim Brown is out. And Reggie Ward is in. They got Jackson and Ward now. Bottom of the picture. Speedster. Berline back. Second down and 15. Little shovel up the middle to Pernell Taylor. And Taylor is inside the 30, down at the 28. 30 seconds to play in the ball game. Notre Dame trying to go without the huddle. Berline's pass thrown to the sidelines, incomplete, off the hands of Ward. Tough pass to catch, and the clock is stopped at 17 seconds. Now you've got one timeout to work with.
But it's
fourth down. You've got fourth down. Do they take the timeout here to talk about it? Obviously, what they've got to do is get themselves wholly and totally organized for John Carney. The ball, the tee is placed down at the 35. It'll be a 45-yard field goal try to win. It's up. He missed it. Ball is hooked off to the left side. So a tough day for John Carney. 13 seconds to play in the ball game. And Notre Dame took it down to the last 13 seconds. Missed the 45-yard field goal try, and Lou Holtz doing everything he can at the moment to restore John Carney. He really hooked that one badly.
You know what was impressive, though? The way Lou Holtz went out and met him and put his arm around him.
Notre Dame spending its last timeout right there, stopping the clock with 10 seconds to play in the ball game. He got one more snap. So let's spend this timeout looking at the respective campuses.
The University of Michigan is a very proud member of a very small set of...
10 seconds to play in the ball game. Jim Harbaugh takes the snap, goes down with it, and that will do it. The Michigan Wolverines have defeated Notre Dame's Fighting Irish, and they were that today by a score of 24 to 23. The Chevy players of the ball game, the MVPs for Michigan. Harbaugh, 15 out of 23, 239 yards and a touchdown. For Notre Dame, Berline, 21 out of 33, 263 yards and a touchdown. Here's Al Trotwig.
Keith, I'm with Lou Holtz. Lou, I think you have a lot to be proud of your team today. A lot of people weren't sure what they had, but I think you have to say at the end of this game, they have a lot.
I'm proud of Notre Dame. I'm proud of it. Just one of those things. I feel bad for the players I've been involved, but it was a great game. We made some mistakes, but golly, it was a great game.
Lou, there was one thing. Berline was brilliant, but your kicker also. At the end of the game, you grabbed him, you said something. What did you say?
Well, you know, we all make mistakes. It's nobody's responsibility. Hey, we're a team. That's all. I love the kid. He's made some great kicks. He'll make some other ones. That's what Notre Dame's about. It's a football experience and an educational experience. And you can't ask any more out of our players.
Were you surprised at all yourself at what your team was able to do today?
I never
Shaq,
know
the computer experts. By the...